Hey guys, I got a super quick video for you today so you can see how to make a moss pole for your plants to climb up in about 5 minutes. I'm going to use this old bamboo stick that was used in a plant delivery for stabilization in the box. I'm going to use this wet sphagnum over here and some tiny little rubber bands to keep it all together. You will not be seeing me in this video because I look like a dragon. That's a girl dragon. I mean, of course you're a girl dragon. So yeah, I'm gonna be extremely disappointed if nobody got that reference. But yeah, this took me almost no time at all. It was so easy. And we're just gonna get started. I'm a super slob, so you'll see I'm doing this on my living room table. No cares in the world. I am wrapping the sphagnum moss onto this pole without any sort of care at all. I'm just putting it on there. And then I take a little rubber band, put it right over top of the sphagnum, and move it to the middle. And would you believe it? It's actually sticking to the stick. It's basically effortless. You just wrap this wet sphagnum onto this stick, bring out a little bit of water, and then you're gonna put a hair tie on it. And the hair ties that I have are actually neon colors, but it doesn't even matter because you can't see it through all of that sphagnum. Does anyone else feel like sphagnum kind of resembles like little bugs, like little cockroaches or centipedes? I don't know. It kind of freaks me out to touch it. Not a super big fan. But as you can see here, I did attempt one wrap with a regular size rubber band, and maybe had I wrapped it a few times, it would not have been as sloppy, but the little rubber bands actually ended up working the best. And sorry, my back is hurting because I am a piece of garbage and don't do anything. So yes, taking another rubber band, scratching myself, and I keep getting sphagnum in my mouth because I have to use my mouth to get my hand on the rubber band. So yeah, don't come for me. This is the life that I live. Welcome. So again, this is taking like almost no time at all, literally zero effort. I am just wrapping sphagnum around this bamboo stick and pushing it up the stick because it's just easier that way. The side that I'm not advancing the sphagnum on is going to be the side that I'm actually going to put into my plant. So, wrapping sphagnum, grab a hair tie, use my mouth, spit it out, and there you go. And then just keep pushing it on. You'll see, it's gonna be a whole lot of that. Super easy. I'd also like to add for anyone that was wondering what the heck I'm doing, I have not watched a single moss pole video. I just am too impatient and figured I could do it myself with my brain and free time. So here we go. This is what I've come up with. No idea how other people are doing it, but I'm gonna be honest. This thing looks pretty good. After looking at it and letting it dry a little bit, it looks pretty good in my Monstera, and it makes total sense. I can spray it with like a Super Thrive solution with my spray bottle, and you'll see where I'm gonna place it is gonna be like right where the aerial node, or the aerial root, excuse me, is actually kind of growing out of the plant and looking for something to grab onto. So this is actually a genius idea, if I don't say so myself. All right, y'all, we are pretty much done here. I think I'm just gonna add a little bit more to fill in some of the holes because it's got some patches in it, but that open part there is what's going to stick down into this pot for my variegated Monstera. I have so much sphagnum in my mouth by this point, it's not even funny. So Maybe if y'all could figure out a better method in regard to that, that would be stupendous. But some of those little dangly things there, I end up trimming them or pulling them off just because it looks like centipedes to me and freaks me out. But otherwise, I mean, this is pretty much the finished product, and that took me no time at all. It was so easy. So obviously all the sphagnum is sitting in a bowl of water, so I am going to wring it out a little bit, but as of this morning after checking on it and leaving it decently moist last night, it is like halfway or at least 3/4 of the way dry, so don't worry about it being like oversaturated or anything like that. It will dry out in your natural environment if you have good ventilation. So these are the rubber bands I used, Dollar Tree Special, the cute little yellow one. And yeah, wring it out, and we're gonna stick it in that plant. This is probably about, I don't know, 12 inches? I don't really know measurements. Looks like 12 inches to me. So that is all there is to that. Let's go ahead and put it in. There's a big old aerial root down there, you can see, and this is the newest leaf that just doesn't seem to wanna grow, so I'm gonna give it something to actually adhere to. Let's show you the finished product. Look at that. Looks so natural. All natural. There we go. And here is a crappy picture of it, but thank you guys for watching.